Hello and welcome to another tutorial by Chris Takakura. This is a tutorial covering all-in-one SEO and just the basic usage of it. I install all-in-one SEO to a lot of my client websites that run on WordPress, and if you are my client or if you're just a beginner with all-in-one SEO, please do check this video out. Now, all-in-one SEO, once you install the plugin or once it is available, there's a tab here that says all-in-one SEO here that gets enabled. Once you mouse over it, and then it will show these four settings right here: general settings, performance, social meta, feature manager. I'm not going to go over every single one, but let's just go to general settings just for now. Now, general settings page will basically, general settings link will basically take you to the general settings area. Now, if you're not sure what you're doing, I strongly suggest you don't touch anything. But if you do know, then by all means, you can mess with all the settings like that's available for you. But I'm just going to go over three basic settings that you can change on your own and won't really necessarily break your website or break search engine results. So the settings is the home page settings, which basically sets tells search engines that's running on WordPress that what your website is about. So the home title basically, says, is your home title. Now, you want to keep this short. This is Chris Takakura, Art Direction Design Blog. That's what my blog is about, and that's my title. So again, if you want to change this section, you can. Just keep it nice and straightforward and short and simple. The home description is basically a short description about your blog. Now, you don't want to make this too long, again, but just want to keep it, again, short and simple. I would suggest having a low minimum word count as possible. But again, this is just basically the gist of what my website is about. And again, you could change the settings to fit your needs or to best describe your business. Now, the home keyword section here is basically keywords that are separated with commas. Now, keywords, there's a lot of statements saying that keywords are not relevant in regards to search engine results anymore, but again, it's better to have something than nothing. So I just kind of added different keywords separated by comma, just to kind of bump up the results if possible. Now, it doesn't have to be hundreds and hundreds of keywords, even though I have a lot here, but just have a good number, like maybe 10, 20 if you can, and then go from there. So once, again, that is set, we're going to go into utilizing all-in-one SEO with all your blog posts and your pages. Now, when you go to your post, you want to click on this link right here that will display all your posts in regards to your blog. So if you've written a lot of blog entries, you should get a list like mine, as you can see here. And once you have all-in-one SEO installed, it enables a new column here called SEO title, SEO description, SEO keywords. Now, what this does is that it assigns different SEO title, description, and keywords based on individual blog posts and pages. This is very important because it indexes your page as a separate page from your home page. If we back in the day, we used to use description and keywords in all of our pages, meaning the title was the same, the description was the same in every single page. Well, times have changed now. There's a better effective method with SEO, and this plugin allows you to do so. Now, to enter the SEO title, SEO description, SEO keywords onto your blog post, we're just going to go to an old blog post that I published. But if you're writing a new one, this is also the same information. So take a look here. Here are the contents and whatnot, and I have an extra section because I have that enabled. And then you have your revisions in here and whatnot, and you know, you might not see everything that you that you're seeing on the screen on your blog page, which is fine because I have plugins installed which enables these things. But on the bottom, once all-in-one SEO is enabled, you should see a window that says all-in-one SEO pack. Now, from here, this is where you enter your title, description, and keywords. Again, don't worry too much about these things right here. It basically, what this does is kind of disables or prevents search engines from following. We don't want to do that today, so let's not even talk about that. So again, we this was very similar to the settings page, but now we're in an individual blog setting, so we're going to have our own unique title, which will be, which what I do is usually use the blog title as long as it's not long enough. This title right here is already using too many characters because it shows you the character count of 69 right here. But most search engines, this says right here, most search engines use a maximum of 60 characters for the title. So maybe we can shorten this and say Adobe Creative Cloud only. This was my blog post. And as you can see up here, the preview snippet, you can see how what it may look like on search engines. And then the description, again, is the same thing as the settings page, but we're going to set a separate description for this page because we're going to write something that's relevant to this article. So this one has its own description that's separate from the home page. And then again, this one also has a separate keywords from that's different from the home page. The keyword section, again, doesn't have to be hundreds and hundreds of keywords, so don't spend too much time on it, but just enter a few keywords that's relevant to the article or blog news that you post. And that's pretty much it. After you fill these out, you're just going to hit the update button right here, just like similar to when you're publishing a blog article, and then it's just going to change the post for you. Now, the proofreader thing came up, so I'm just going to hit OK. And then once we hit OK, it's going to take us to the edit post page. And it's going to say post updated and view post. Now let's go back to the list, our blog list. And as you can see, my SEO title has changed to Adobe Creative Cloud and my description and my keywords. So that is one method of entering SEO separately from with each an individual article. This is a really good tactic to use in terms of search engine results. Just take the time every time you publish a blog, take the time to put in the SEO title, SEO description, SEO keywords, because it will benefit you in the long run. Now, when you want to enter separate SEO information on your pages, you go to the pages section right here. So I'm just going to click on pages. It's going to show you all the pages that's currently live on your site, or not live. It will say draft if it's not live, but if it's live, then you could just choose the pages. Now, I don't really use pages on my blog because it's strictly a blog, but I have some few examples up here. So let's just go to edit. And again, the page editing section is just like a blog post. Nothing too different on outside of page attributes. We don't have to really worry about that today. But again, you see how there's this option here called All-in-One SEO Pack. And again, you have an option to enter the title, description, and keywords. Now, one thing I did not go over with individual blog post is the social settings, and I'm going to go over that with you now. But social settings basically is when someone were to share your article on a social networking site like Facebook and whatnot, you can also choose to have SEO settings separate from the main settings. So the title could be anything, something maybe different. Or it could be something, it could be the same, to be honest. The description can be the same or something different. And then over here, you can see it says image. These options increase in terms of options depending on how many number of pictures you used on the blog post. So you can actually choose what images show up. For instance, if someone shared your blog content on Facebook or Twitter, these images will show up as a kind of like a preview image on Facebook. For instance, if you share it on a Facebook like page, your own like page, if I select this image will show up and say, check out this page or check out this blog post by yada, yada, yada. So this is where you kind of choose your image, or you can choose a custom image and upload it if you want. I just usually use a picture that's already been used on a blog article and go from there. Don't worry too much about specify image width, image height. Don't worry too much about Facebook object type, and don't worry too much about Twitter card type. Unless you know what you're doing, you can choose summary large image or photo. But again, these are just individual settings for your social network. So again, the pages and the post SEO settings are really not different, but it's still something really important to do. Make sure you have separate SEO information on different pages relevant to that page. So for instance, if you have like a gallery, then you would have a title here called gallery, and then that's it. So all you have to do is type gallery, and the best part about all-in-one SEO pack is after you type in gallery, it will automatically follow up with the website title of your whole entire page. So if mine's called Chris Takakura Art Direction Design, if I put gallery on the title bar of the browser, or the title for the page will be called gallery Chris Takakura Art Direction and Design. And again, have something different for your description that's relevant to your page. If you have a gallery, let's say if you have a gallery page, make the description, this is the gallery page of My Business Incorporated and whatnot. So again, keep it relevant to that page, but remember to always have something different for each page for the best search engine results. I hope this video helped you. Again, this is just a very basic, broad overview of all-in-one SEO. If you have any more questions or whatnot, you're always welcome to email me. But I hope this covered some ground for you. Thank you very much.